Everybody, it's Taylor Roberts, and welcome to Off the Deep End. Guys, we've officially entered spooky season. It is officially October 1st, which October is one of my favorite months of the year because it happens to have one of my favorite holidays of the year, which is Halloween. And I enjoy Halloween because I get to dress up and pretend to be somebody other than who I pretend to be every single day of my life. But before we get started, remember new videos drop on this channel every week. So make sure you subscribe, make sure you hit that bell button so you get notifications of when those new videos drop. Hop on over to Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, and give me a follow. Last but not least, Patreon link down in the description. Go and check that out if you got the time. And guys, let's get right into it. Ooh, you're right. It's already spooky right off the bat. Oh shit. Oh, it transitions. Good to know. I guess I'm going to stop the songs during the middle of the song since there's transitions. I don't want to fuck up the flow of the album, but that opening song was the perfect song, I think. It just set the mood 100%. You know, we get the theme of the album, right? We get the mood, we get the atmosphere of it all, but we also get the tone and kind of the vibe and the energy that I'm hoping is going to be throughout this entire album. Dancing while you're dying type feel. I will say, though, this song reminds me of Titanium by David Guetta. Ain't no prayer that can save you now. Ain't nobody can hear you shout. When I'm pulling you underground. Let me talk about that last track real quick. Like I mentioned, it definitely reminded me of Titanium with Sia and David Guetta on his track, which, by the way, I love that track. So I love this one as well, just because they sound so similar to each other, but obviously, you know, it's completely different meaning behind the song. But what I really love about it is that, yes, it has this kind of slasher Halloween movie feel to it, but it's not so much in your face. Like, she keeps the vibe of that, but still it has this very trancey electronic feeling almost like you're at a lit ass Halloween party. You're out of time. Woo! Shit. I'm sorry. those scents are nice. Transition into the next song here. Loving the transitions on this album. Almost hate having to pause these songs to talk because it's just I feel like I'm killing the vibe when I'm doing it, but Jesus, that last Bloody Valentine, I love how it was literally almost, there was like no lyrics at all, but it still managed to keep the same vibe and the same energy flowing, and we didn't really need to know it almost kind of felt like an interlude a bit into this next song. The album, the fluidity from song to song, from energy to from vibe to vibe has just been excellent right now. Switch up. The production on this album is just fire right now. Synth wave aspect of these songs, especially this one, is just coming in hard right now. I feel like this album is kind of like if you took Thriller by Michael Jackson, reproduced it for the digital music age, and then made a whole entire album based on Thriller is kind of what this album is. The production, the sequencing in the production for some of the songs had to be a pain in the ass. Because it's just so on point and there's so much going on. Lyric-wise, the lyrics are very kind of basic. It has that kind of pop, you know, that kind of simple, generic pop kind of lyrics. But at the same time, you know, she's done a great job of being able to portray a certain feeling or a certain vibe. And just the effects, just the amount of production that she's put on the vocals to add that sort of extra layer of energy into those songs has just been flawless. Like, I really, really love the creativity on these songs right now. Well, listen to that. Listen to the sequencing on this. And these transitions have just been flawless as well. God, so beautiful, man. This song is straight out of Nightmare Before Christmas. It sounds like a song straight out of Nightmare Before Christmas. Just with the overall sound and having that Halloween feel, but the way she's delivering her lyrics, that melody is that Christmas song. I don't remember the name of it. It was that one. I can't remember the name of it. Love when you beg, love when you cry. Queen of the dead, that which I am, reborn again. I never end, I never die. Don't let me in, I see the sin under your skin. You can't escape, you can't deny. Seek and I find, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. I really love the lead melody on this song, though. It really does remind me of, like, some 80s slasher movie. Sounds like a fucking massacre. She was right. It's also definitely got that 80s Stranger Things vibe going with it as well in the music. It's like an 80s Stranger Things horror slasher album. Yeah. That's really all I can say. So far, this album has been incredible. I really love the addition of the knives coming in for the percussion too. It's a nice, really nice touch. This one's called Death by Sex. Wouldn't be a bad way to go, right? Like that, you know, that Halloween night, 2 a.m. wearing pumpkin masks going at it type music. That is not from personal experience, by the way. I don't wear a pumpkin mask. I wear Michael Myers because I am gonna slash that. This is some exorcist shit. Loving this album so far. 9 songs in. We're about 9 songs in now. Loving it. I love how there's just some songs with no lyrics at all. It's just straight music. It really just helps you kind of lose yourself more into the overall kind of ambience and feeling that this album gives off. But then, you know, you have the songs that do have the lyrics, which kind of drive the story along. And so far, we've got everything in here that makes a nice Halloween slasher film. You got horror, you got murder, you got blood, you got sex, you got it all. You got demons up in this bitch. We just need a masked killer and you're set. You hit all the classic, iconic Halloween stories, movies. This is beautiful too. I'm really loving the way that she's playing with the sonics of her voice. Gonna build up into something crazy. I already know it. I'm sorry, guys. My nose keeps itching for some reason. I'm not doing cocaine, I swear. Yet. No, don't do that. It's bad. Drugs are bad. Here we go, baby. You take a drag, I take a sip. I want your legendary kiss. You know I got designer taste, and your design's too good to waste. When the breeze comes out at night, yeah, it always wants a bite. And I try to resist, but then the devil always wins. Yeah. Now, knowing this is my first time listening to Kim Petras, I don't know how to say her last name. Petras, I think it's Petras. I don't really know anything about her. Is she a singer, or is she a DJ, or is she both? Because this really does sound like, you know, you're at some Halloween-themed rave, and you're just completely fucked up, jumping up and down. Ah. I really wish we had like a smoke machine here and some lights. That's what we need. I need to get one of those like little like smoke cannons that shoot out every time like a beat drops. I can just press the button and it'll be like cool. It'll be like we're at a little rave in my office. There we go, this is what we need, a little party. Gonna get over these transitions. This is so smooth, man. It's just non-stop. Oh my god. I know this came out in 2019, right? At least that's what it says on Spotify, 2019. I can't believe I haven't heard this album. Then again, you know, I don't really listen to a whole lot of pop music. Pop is a little bit out of my genre. Although I listened to a lot of pop music when I was younger, kid. Pop music, is just, you know, I've just been more into hip-hop and R&B and all of that. But this, man, I am so impressed with this right now. Listen to all the different types of sounds she's experimenting with too in the production. Okay, I will say, I know this is the title track, but this one, I'm not feeling too much compared to all the other ones so far. I love the kind of lead bass melody we got going on. I'm not digging the lyrics too much. I mean, it doesn't throw off the overall vibe of the album. It fits the overall vibe of the album. I think this one has just been a lot more kind of simpler than a lot of the other songs.
Come on.
Yeah, that one was a good song. Not my favorite so far, but still super danceable. I'm just not vibing with the song as much as I was with the other songs. And, you know, it's a 17 song album. And I feel like, you know, an album that has more than you know, maybe 12, 13 songs tops can sometimes just be some filler. And I think these last two, even though that last one was a title track, might be a little bit of just kind of filler songs. I mean, they still work. They're still danceable. They're still fun. It's just, you know, I don't think he necessarily needed them. I'm petting my dog right now. My light just went out. Did you see that? My light just flickered out and died. Hang on 1 second. So my light just totally bugged out on me for no reason. And now it doesn't want to turn on. So I guess we're going to keep it like this for the rest of the thing, right? Fuck it. Let's keep going. Okay. I love these little songs she has where there's no vocals on them at all. I don't know. It just lets you party. You don't have to focus on anything but the music, and you can just rage and have a good time. And I know some of these songs would be dope live too, or at the club, like a Halloween party at the club with these songs would just be so lit. I might just throw my own Halloween party here at my house by myself. 'Cause you know, social distancing. Ooh. Okay. God, that was hard. I thought this was going to take a completely different turn at first. Just the way it started has just been so different compared to, you know, kind of what we listened to. But as soon as that drop came in, took us right back to that party mode. For entertainment. Yeah, that one was okay too. It was all right. Break. Everybody dies. This is interesting. Not everybody feels. What? This just took a complete 180. What is this? What is this song? We've just been partying our ass off, killing people, you know, having nasty sex, and all of a sudden it's turned into 1950s, grab your girl, hold your girl, because everybody dies. Thank you. I think it's kind of weird that for the very last song, she took it in a completely different direction as far as the structure and the genre of the music for the very last song. Although she could have done that on purpose just because it sticks out a lot. And you know, the message of saying not everybody lives, but everybody dies is like basically saying, you know, you're alive, like live your life, like do your thing, keep living your life. You know, don't just pass through life just stone faced and not feeling anything. Like go out and do your thing because eventually you're going to die. Anyways, we're all going to die. So just do it. I think it's a good little message to close out the album. As far as the album, though, guys, I really, really, really enjoyed this album. I honestly have never heard of this artist before until you guys recommended her. Like I said, I'm not a huge pop music guy. So a lot of the artists that you guys send me, most of the time I've never heard of them because I just don't pay attention to the genre too much. But I'm glad my YouTube channel now is centered around pop and indie pop and alternate pop, because now I'm getting introduced to all these amazing artists that I've never just paid attention to because wasn't the type of music that I listened to. And I'm discovering some new stuff. So thank you guys for requesting it. Things I loved about the album. I really loved the cohesiveness of it. The overall cohesiveness of the project was executed really, really well. The fluidity of the album from the transitions, the mixture of just straight instrumental music to music with lyrics in them. It really kind of gave a nice overall balance to the album. The theme of the album was great. It's unique. Some of my favorite songs on this one, I'm trying to remember which ones. There was a majority of them I really, really loved. Death by Sex was awesome. Knives, I loved, was awesome. There Will Be Blood, Purgatory, a majority, one through like, we'll say 1 through 11, I loved. The only ones that I didn't really like too much was Turn Off the Light, Tell Me It's a Nightmare, Everybody Dies. But I feel like if I listen to Everybody Dies again, it's going to grow on me a little bit. Actually, I feel like all these songs that I mentioned that I didn't care for, if I listen to them again, they're going to grow on me. But yeah, I loved it, guys. I thought it was great. And considering looking at the albums that came out last year, I think this might have been, one of the top albums to come out, even though I haven't even heard it until now. But let me know your guys' thoughts down in the comments, guys. What are your favorite songs? What do you not like? And let me know a little bit more about Kim Petras. If you guys want me to do some more reactions to her, let me know down in the comments and like the video. Remember, new videos drop on this channel every week, so make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell button so you get notifications of when those new videos drop. Hop on over to Instagram, hop on Twitter, Twitch, and give me a follow. Last but not least, there's a Patreon link down in the description. Go and check that out if you got the time. And that is all I got for you. So, take care. Stay safe. Hey, thanks for watching Off the Deep End. Make sure you subscribe, comment, like, and share, and feel free to explore our channel and check out some of our other videos. Remember, new videos drop every week. Take care.